Friends, hails to all you extreme metal fans out there. Today for review we have Goatspell. Now this is a name that would, in my opinion, indicate some sort of, say, blasphemy copycat war metal band with just totally dissonant soundscape and blurry sounds. But on the contrary, this is a very positive surprise. As you can see, this is an LP. Well, the picture is right behind me as well. But this is an EP length of a release, so 12 inch with 4 tracks, about 18 minutes if I remember correctly. Inside we have, of course, the vinyl, double-sided, 2 songs per side obviously, and then we have this lyrics sheet, which has lyrics on the other side, nicely done, and then some band photo and lineup information. To be honest, I don't know why there's a 5 band members mentioned, only picture of 2, and that's exactly what actually the Metal Archives told me as well. So two band members versus 5, don't know really what's the story, but that's kind of beside the point. Let's talk about the music. Now Goatspell hasn't been there around for too long. There's no full-length albums out yet, just some of these kind of mini-releases, EP, demo, whatever. But the thing here is, it's a really nice EP combining the best elements of death metal, black metal and thrash metal. Mainly we could say it's all about black metal, but those thrashy elements, even heavy metal elements are there, and then some death as well. If this does ring a bell and sounds familiar, well, thinking bands like Destroyer 666, you're exactly right. There are those melodic parts which are very, very reminiscent of Destroyer 666. And also those kind of chaotic fast parts of the extreme metal style, more kind of a death track, thrash black, are something that remind me of, once again, Destroyer 666 and also Niflheim, the Swedish band. One could even say that American band Usurper has some similarities, but obviously it's a bit different as well. Destroyer 666 is definitely the closest I could imagine when the time I was listening to this EP quite a few times, and I gotta say, it's pretty damn nice. It's not totally top-notch. It's good to use even more to so-called hit riffs and, you know, memorability, you know, the kind of a catchiness. So it kind of has also those riffs and parts which are not that easy to, you know, just, you know, sink in your brain, and then you will just like see yourself humming or listen to them rather than sing. But you know what I mean. The thing is, it's nice to get into. It's kind of a energetic, it's violent, aggressive, the kind of stuff you would maybe enjoy having a couple of beers with before going out with your friends or to see a gig at a festival. But since it's only an EP, it's not so much a full experience as an album. But anyway, it's a nice way to get to know this band, and since it's also a nice looking vinyl, why the hell not? If you doubt my words, which you should always do, go check out the samples and decide for yourself. But I think for Black Death Thrash hybrid heads, this is definitely a must give a go release. So with that information, do your clicking, do your listening, and enjoy some brutal stuff. See ya.